You know, Dad does want grandchildren to carry on his name. But that is a serious operation.
Very serious. And he won't hear of adoption. We could adopt children.
Well, if we did that, it wouldn't really be his name that is carrying on.
But if we adopted an infant, we could bring that child up just like none of us.
Well, he don't look at it either way.
So instead, he'll marry your sister off to breed her.
You don't seem to be all that bad of a person. I tell you what, if you behave, then I just might give you a job pushing broom come closing time.
Well, fair enough.
Jody, pour the man a drink. Oh no, here comes Mr. Robinson. Always complaining about not having any grandchildren.
Well, just let me out of here. I don't want to get in this conversation.
See me?
Yeah.
That's a good girl. Well, what do you got there for me?
Whatever you need.
Stronger the better, babe.
Stronger the better.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, but have you seen my boy around here, Sammy?
Jody, I'm gonna go to the back and check on some supplies.
Down, you know, I was hoping my boy would have some children by now. You know, after 5-6 years now, you know, hey, when are they gonna have some kids?
Yeah.
You know, and after all my age, you know, how much longer am I gonna be around?
That's right.
So, Yeah, I kind of hope my boy would do something. After all, he's got a... When I'm gone, they're gonna have a lot of property.
Hey, child, I heard your mouth.
Listen.
I won't say nothing. Okay, now you're up
there. Watch it, buddy!
Sorry to hear about that.
Sure,
don't mess around.
Yes, we are. Sure. Well, Lee, so good to see you. So glad you're able to come. Oh, incidentally, over here, my good friend. This is my friend here. Lee, I want you to meet my daughter. Zelda.
Why? It's a pleasure to meet you.
Sorry to hear about your mother.
Thank you. I'll miss her.
And also, this is my son, Sammy.
Nice meeting you. Glad you could come.
And this is his lovely wife, Helen. So, this way things happen, you know. Lee, come to think of it, I'd like for you to sit with us at the church.
Shepherd, I shall not be in want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He restores my soul. He guides me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen.
Okay, gang. Well, the limo's here. Let's go.
She's gone. I've been seeing her in church. It's almost every Sunday. Hard to believe it.
Well, I tell you, I would like to have known. It's just, you know, a pleasure meeting you all. You know, maybe we could just met under different circumstances. But I don't really know what to tell you, what to say.
I'm gonna miss Mama. She was a good cook, and that's one thing I can say I inherited from Mama. I know she's watched me every time it's a sunny day. I know Mama's smiling. It's coming my way. And I miss you, Mama, and I love you.
Warren, I keep thinking back when I was a kid and how she helped me out, and I
just can't believe it.
Remember Shiloh's going over to the house, fix those warm apple pies.
She was a good cook, wasn't she?
Yeah.
I'm gonna miss her a lot too.
I'm gonna miss her. I don't know how I'm gonna get along without her. She always treated me just like a daughter. She was such a good woman to everybody. Just to everybody.
Yeah, she mended my clothes, always looking out for me.
She helped me find God.
And I won't have her to talk to anymore.
Well, what do you think of my farm here, Lee?
Nice little place.
It certainly is. And let me tell you, it's a lot of work on this tobacco farm. A lot of work. Not easy. You got a lot of land out here. Yep. Of course, my boy Sammy, you know, he's married. And his wife, Helen, good kids. Now, the only one I got, is not married yet. But I'm looking forward to her getting married. Zelda. Very beautiful daughter. Very sweet girl. Incidentally, you ever thought about getting married, Lee?
Well, it's a thought.
I know you're being a drifter. Incidentally, listen, I've been a drifter in my life, too, before I got all this. And let me tell you, I've been through it, man. Texas, Arizona, had some rugged times on them roads and highways. It's a rough life. But I kind of miss it in a way, but it's not like having your own place. You can really enjoy it, it's yours, do what you like with it, work when you want to work, raise a family. What do you think, kid?
It's a thought.
Yeah. Anyway, I think it'd be nice if you and Zelda get together. You know, I'm kind of hitting to you, kid, but I think you find her to be a nice girl. Two people can get together and do, you know, wonders. What do you think?
It's a thought.
I knew I'd count on you, pal.
And he won't hear of adoption. We could adopt children.
Well, if we did that, it wouldn't really be his name if it's carrying on.
But if we adopted an infant, we could bring that child up just like one of us.
Well, he don't look at it, by the way.
So instead, he'll marry your sister off to breed her.
Well, I don't think much of that Ryan fella.
I don't either.
I wish I'd never saw him. He's nothing but trouble, the way I look at it.
He's just after your daddy's money.
That's what I'm thinking.
I'll be right out.
Dad is really glad to see you stay on. You're just like a son to him.
Well, this feels just like home to me.
I just stopped by to see how you were making it.
Well, thank you very much, Jim. I'm glad you were concerned. Yep, 2 weeks already. Man, it's hard to take. Martha's not with us no more. It's
sad. Real sad. Great girl. A real pal. She was there when I always needed her. She was a real partner. And my raising those two kids, Sammy and Zelda. I mean, what a mother. But it was sad the way she had to go. I don't know, I just can't get over it, man. I'm shaking up over it. But I gotta continue working around here, gotta keep things rolling. But that's the way Martha would want it. Yeah?
I heard that Mr. Ryan is still with you.
Yeah. Yeah, he's still working for me. Nice boy. Nice boy.
I thought it over. And I'm not going to run for the next election. And I'll take that foreman's job if you'll have me.
You mean you're going to quit being our local sheriff? I never thought it would come to that end. You did a super job. People in this area think the world of you. You always had my vote. But if you want to hook up with me, kid, you're welcome to it. My word is my bond. You want that job, Jim, you got it.
Thank you very much.
Where's that stranger at?
Oh.
He was supposed to be here for breakfast, you know.
True, true. You mean my future son-in-law.
Future son-in-law?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, right. Don't you know what you're doing? You're putting that stranger ahead of your own flesh and blood. And you're pushing somebody on Zelda all the time.
Not really. Listen, after all, when he married Zelda, I got my fingers crossed. And after all, he's a nice boy. He's helping me around here.
I understand.
He's going out of his way. After all, how many people would actually do that?
If he
married Zelda, I'm willing to give up 50 acres. And of course, Sammy's got the other 50.
Right.
Sammy's going to be in control of things around here.
Uh-huh.
And it's going to be Zelda's as well. And Zelda is going to have to eventually get married. It's not living in a big city where she's going to go out and make her big choice of different people around. It's a small place. It's good country down here in North Carolina. And I think, after all, I got a feeling that she's kind of falling in love with the guy.
Oh, okay. She's
very pretty.
Yes.
Aren't you, darling? Ain't you, baby? Tell me.
Yeah. I took after mother.
That's right.
I took after mother. Mother would let me make up my own mind, Daddy.
Uh-huh. That's true.
Yeah.
Martha would.
She would.
Mm-hmm. She really would.
You know, I know your dad really wants kids. He wants us to have kids. And it's not that I don't want to. I'm just really afraid of that operation. It's dangerous. And they said I might not even make it through it. Doesn't he understand that?
Dad does want grandchildren bad to carry on his name. But it is a serious operation.
Hear them beautiful birds singing? Isn't that great? Great country out here.
Nice, Mr. Robinson. Very nice.
Well, that's North Carolina for you. Favorite place. Really, in the old days, I never thought I'd make it down here. But anyway, Yeah, we're doing pretty good. We're getting things kind of wrapped up around here. I hope you stay on with us for some time. I sure hate to miss you and see you leave. Incidentally, listen, we're going to church services this weekend. How about you coming down and being my guest?
Well,
maybe this Sunday.
Well, let's put it this way. You're welcome any Sunday. We'd love to have you, kid. Yep. So I gather you sort of enjoy being here. You think I got a pretty good family?
I think a lot of your family, Mr. Robson. Very fine family.
Yeah, like I said, that's put a lot of effort to it. Turned out pretty good. And knowing people like you, you know, that's a real treat. You know, there should be actually more people like you.
Dave, I'm sorry I missed you at the office. What can I do for you?
The Fosters are bringing a malpractice suit against me. Doctor, I really admire you for what you're doing. You work around the clock, helping save lives, yet most of us would be dead if it weren't for you. But when things don't go right, patients want to crucify you. So what can I do for you? Lady Foster fell, and on the first x-ray, it did not show. A month later, it showed as a break. And the family's trying to sue me for it.
Well, Doctor, I'll do what I can.
Well, Dave, it's about church time. Hope to see you in church.
I'll do that.
Well, I just happened to be at the right place at the right time and did the right thing. Your father sees everything in me that I want him to see in me, and I feel good about it. You know what he's got in mind for the both of us. He wants us to get married.
Thank you.
be Jim!
Yeah!
Come on in, boy! Come on in!
Hello, Sheriff.
Good morning, Claudette.
You've been running late today.
Zelda.
Good morning.
Thought I'd stop by and have a cup of coffee with you.
Yeah, we got that coffee for you.
Coffee.
We got plenty of coffee.
Have a seat right here.
Thank you.
You're running late today.
Yes, I know. It's that things has been hectic today and...
What, the troublemakers down at the bar again?
That's right.
Oh,
the troublemakers driving me up a wall.
What they've done this time?
How about showing me around?
Sure, why not? Why not? Big enough. Plenty here to do. And it's weird. The older you get, seems like there's always so much work to be done. Sometimes it seems like it's never, never done. But I tell you, I mean, I had good health. Really good health. And, you know, that's what counts. I always feel, you know, you're good as your health. If your health is good, it makes me good. You make me look good. You being here, that tops it all. You being an old farm boy here down in North Carolina. And you, listen, you know the game.
I've never worked on a 100-acre farm, so.
Yeah, but you'll get used to it. And I got news. I'm gonna miss you being a chef around here.
Yeah.
In fact, I was gonna vote for you next time. Okay. Now, let me show you around, Jim.
Fine.
Good man. Good man. Good man.
You know, Mr. Brawler, I don't know that I can take this farm life. I mean, Mr. Robinson, he expects me to get up at 4:00 in the morning, feed the hogs. He's wanting to teach me how to milk a cow, and well, they're gonna start priming tobacco next week, and I don't know that I can take it.
Yeah, you'll be able to. It just takes a little while to get used to it. Once you get started, then you'll probably be able to fall right in there. Do it. Shouldn't be a bit of trouble for you.
Well, if you'll show me what to do, well, we can start.
Okay, you ready to do some hoeing?
Ourselves. And you kids, we'll be back. Won't be late, promise you that.
Okay.
So, Sam, take care of the ladies till we get back.
Okay.
Are you ready, sir?
Let's go.
Right on.
I'm ready. We're
gone.
Oh, boy. I'm ready.
Did you see that? He's putting that rind over his own flesh and blood.
Now, just calm down. When I get a chance, I'm going to talk to Mr. Robertson about all this going on. Calm down.
You know, Helen, it's nice to get out like this and listen to the crickets and a nice walk and be together in the quietness of the farm and just look over the farm and all the farmland and walk around it. and go back to nature and listen to the crickets and the birds sing, with old Bubba coming along walking with us. Isn't it great?
It is. It's really nice.
Really great.
I just hope we don't have to lose part of this.
Me too. That's really got me worried. Seemed like things are going so good, now here comes trouble.
I know. And you've worked so hard for your dad. And you've just given him your all.
No, it's just, I don't know what we're going to do, but it's really got me worried. It really has. I hope things will work out soon. If only that Ryan guy had not come into the picture.
Just some way to get rid of him.
Yeah, and Zelda seems to be so much in love with him. I hope it's some way that she can see the light and see what him for what he really is. But time will tell.
While the men are out in the fields working, I need to have a talk with you.
Okay.
Your father is putting Lee Ryan ahead of Sammy, his own flesh and blood. I don't understand that.
Colette, you're reading this all wrong. Daddy's reliving his childhood. It helps keep him young to buddy around with Lee Ryan. You've just got to understand that.
Okay, I understand. But your father needs to put more interest in this family and his son Sammy.
Keeping things rolling, looking good all the time. Hear the cattle? Background. Yeah. Cheerful place, romantic. Everything what a man really needs. It comes with living, you know, the way you want to make things happen. It's really up to you. Hear the cattle?
Okay. Farmland, I think.
They can always hear it when the master speaks. That means they're happy as well. Harmony. What a life. It beats that old city life.
Well, that's something to think about. It's...
Her hip bones could have shattered apart after the x-rays.
Well, we've got one thing going for us, Doc. She didn't die on the operating table. And the operation was a success.
I'm not agreeing to a settlement because I'm not guilty.
If she would have died during the operation, the jury might would point their finger at us. But as things stand now, we stand a good chance.
I usually stop by around 8:30 for a cup of coffee, but you called me earlier, and is anything wrong?
No, there's nothing wrong. We're just throwing a surprise birthday party for Mr. Robertson. And can you get him down at the community building if you can work it into your schedule?
Yes, I think that can be arranged.
On this occasion, Father, we just ask that everything we say and everything we do might be used as a blessing to glorify your holy name. Father, we ask that you bless each person here today. Give them prayers and mercies as they return their homes. Father, we thank you especially today for the food. Bless the hands who prepared it. Use it to nourish your bodies. And may our lives be a living witness to the love of Jesus. We pray in his name.
Precious in peace, hallelujah, hallelujah, blood of my soul, in the stillness of the
Sam, I would like to have a little talk with you. You know, sort of a man-to-man talk.
Okay. Shoot, Dad.
Yeah. Would it really help to have some grandchildren? So they could go on and carry my name.
Look, Dad, Helen will have to have an operation to have children. And it might not go well. I feel like it should be our decision to have children, not yours.
Yeah, let me tell you, Sam. My firstborn, Anna, lovely girl. She got married to a
a fellow that was really twice her age. Nice man. But the poor man died of a heart attack before he produced any children. Too bad. Too bad.
Hey, Sam?
No, thanks, Dad. Not right now. It's fresh.
People don't get married for breeding purposes. That's why Anna left home. She got tired of hearing it.
Well, yeah. At least it's been real dry and hot.
How you doing?
Step in my office.
After you, sir.
Please.
I'll be with you shortly. Yeah.
Have a seat.
Fine. Thank you very much, Mr. Johnson.
So, Conrad, what's on your mind?
Well, a few things.
Tell me about it.
Well, actually, I want you to draw up a contract for me.
Mr. Johnson, I need for you to write up a contract for me. I'm offering 50 acres of my land to David Lee Ryan. Providing that he marries my daughter. And of course, I want this in writing.
Mr. Robertson, if I didn't know you better, I'd think that you was trying to persuade Mr. Ryan into marrying your daughter.
Now I'm a pretty good judge of characters. Now, Lee wants to marry my daughter, Zelda. And of course, I know he's not marrying her for the land.
Mr. Robertson, that's not a good idea. Now, you know that marriages don't always work out. And if they go their separate ways, Mr. Ryan will have the land. Now, my advice to you is put the land in your daughter's name. That way, the land will always stay in the family.
No, no. I want Mr. Ryan's name on that contract.
So be it, Mr. Robertson. But I've got to give you my personal advice. After all, that's what you're paying me for.
Did you see that? He's putting that Ryan over his own flesh and blood.
Yeah, I would sure like to have some grandchildren so they can go on, carry my name. Carry my name through.
Mr. Robertson, I understand that you like to hang around Lee Ryan. And you're always on Zelda about getting married. But you need to show more interest in your son, Sammy. And this family.
They have some grandchildren. So they could go on and carry carry my name.
I hear that you're going to sign half of that land over to that stranger Ryan if he marries Zelda. I just don't think that's right.
Well, I understand what you're saying, Sam. But you can remember, Zelda's going to have to get married. And after all, I kind of like that boy. He's not a bad boy. I know he's a... You know, we don't know that much about him, but, you know, getting to know him. I like him. I know you like him as well. And, of course, I know Zelda's in love. So that's what's important. Of course, he's going to get 50%. But you got to remember, it's going to belong to Zelda as well. And we got to make sure that she's happy. And she's way overdue getting married. So I kind of feel that, I think that's fair enough.
Hi, Helen, how are you?
I'll tell you the truth, Zelda, I'm not sure.
What's wrong?
There's so much stuff going on around here, I just don't know. I've just been worried to death. Worried sick for Sammy. It's this stuff with this Ryan guy is about to drive him crazy. And your daddy. He's acting like a, I don't know, he acts like he's 14 years old.
Yeah, he enjoys being around Lee. He really does. He makes him feel young again. And, you know, Daddy wants to see me marry this guy.
Yeah, but do you want to marry this guy?
If there's a chance I may. I just don't know, Helen. I just don't know.
But what do you know about him?
I know he's a nice guy.
Well, I've worked these fields by the sweat of my brow. And I've heard if you marry my sister, you're going to get half of the farm. And it's just not right. It's just not right.
Well, I mean, the way I hear it, your father has over 100 acres of land. Now, the way I see it, if I don't marry your sister, I mean, somebody else will, and the way I see it, I'm just as entitled to the land as them.
No, Pa just wouldn't sign that land over to just anybody.
Well, you've got a good-looking sister. I mean, I can say that. Good-looking sister.
Well, I'm sorry I missed you at the office, so I stopped by to see you.
What I wanted to talk to you about was this house.
Well, it's a nice house. Go on.
Well, this house was a shell when I first moved here. And Mr. Robertson told me if I'd fix this place up, that I could live here as long as I wanted to. But I don't know. I just wonder what's going to happen if... Mr. Lee Ryan gets the land.
Well, now, if Mr. Robertson signs the land over to Mr. Ryan, he'll have the right to put you out.
Well, it's about church time.
Well, that's good. Let's get there.
See you in church.
Yes, sir. You too.
Robertson, cannot understand how come you're not going to church.
Well, I have been to church, but he expects me to go every Sunday. I just don't know what Mr. Robertson expects out of me.
I understand.
I'm getting to understand how his son, Sammy, feels.
Yeah, it's every day. He don't miss a day that he's not talking about wanting grandkids. I don't understand him, though. He's just been like a different person since Martha passed away. But you brightened his spirits when you came to town. And you're a good sort of fella.
Thank you. Well, you know, Sammy, you got over 100 acres of land here. Over 100 acres of land. I mean, I'll take the cows or I'll take the tobacco fields. I mean, either one's all right with me. I mean, just what do you want? I mean, just what do you want?
What do you mean? What do you mean what I want? I don't want you to have none of it. It don't belong to you. It belongs to my sister Zelda and me. It's our farm, not yours. You're just a stranger here. You're an outsider.
My father's trying to talk that Ryan man into marrying my younger sister, Zelda. And if he does, half of that farmland will go to him.
Well, Sammy, you still have half. I mean, that's quite a bit the way I look at it. So how much is enough?
Well, it's just not right. I've worked them fields from daylight till dark by the sweat of my brow. It's just not right that an outsider can come in here and take it like that.
You know, that's not right, that man getting your land like that.
Yeah, we got a score to settle with that man.
Why don't you bust him up when he comes back in here?
I'd like to, but no, we've had enough trouble in this place. Let me tell you this, there's a place for it.
Mr. Bryan.
Yes, sir. How you doing?
Just fine. Are you?
Just fine.
I just stopped by to let you know that Bill and myself will be furnishing refreshments for the workers in the field.
That's good. That's good. Glad to hear that. Glad to hear that. We need all the help we can get someday.
Hope that you get ready and come to church later on.
Oh, yes, sir. I'll be there.
Good. Look forward to seeing you.
Mm-hmm.
Good day.
Good day.
Well, Vernon, I thought Mr. Robertson had better sense than that.
Well, he's just trying to persuade Mr. Ryan to marry his daughter. But he's got it wrote out in the contract. If there's a separation, the land will go back to the children.
Well, what if there's not any children? What if Zelda dies first and Mr. Ryan's left?
Well, it's just like you say it. It's
bad judgment.
Mister, you got lucky. You took us by surprise. You ain't gonna be lucky this time, boy. We're gonna bust you up. You hear me?
You caught us by surprise. It's gonna be a different story this time. You can believe that.
Well, I'm a grifter. I've ran into situations like this. I've taken my share of bruises along the way. There's no hard feelings. Hey, those guys, they beat me up bad. Just don't think that I'm gonna make it to church this Sunday.
My gosh, Lee, what happened to you?
Those guys, they beat me up good.
I think I need to go call Sheriff Jim Blake right now.
No, he gave me a break in the bar. I'm just not gonna go crying to him now.
Well, that's awful swollen, Lee.
Maybe he needs to go to the hospital, see a doctor.
I think we need to keep eyes supplied to it, or he's gonna have one shiner.
Well, I don't know that I'm gonna be able to make it to church this Sunday. It's just, I can't. I just don't want all these people staring at me.
It don't matter if they stare at you, Lee.
Yeah, man's the name of the game. It's gonna be okay. Yeah, it's too bad about Lee taking a bad beating the other day. You know, those were the same devils that we fought with when I first met Lee, when Lee stepped in and helped me out. I mean, they were tough boys, rednecks, whatever you want to call them. They were bad boys. Well, I feel like the guy got the beating that he deserved.
Didn't it help Lee? Now, don't get me wrong. I know Lee can handle him. He can handle anything. Man, when I seen that guy jump in, when he helped to save me from them buggers, I mean, he was a whirlwind. I mean, he can tear these guys up apart. But you still should have stepped in to help him regardless.
You know, my dad sees everything in that man that he doesn't see in me. It's bad to lose the respect of your father.
Do you remember when I was in sixth grade and Billy Smith walked up and knocked my books out of my hand? You walked right up to him and punched him in the nose. And you told him that if he ever knocked my books out of my hand again, you'd hit him again. You're the same man that you were then. Honey, don't let anybody tell you different.
We just come down to see if you's okay. You know, you spent a lot of time back here fooling around on the river, checking on you.
Hey, well, I just thought y'all came by to beat me up again.
Well, Sammy was embarrassed about the things his father said and about not having children, and we don't really want any hard feelings about all this, so we just come down here to set things right.
I wasn't gonna try to hurt Mr. Robinson. He just kind of tripped.
Sammy, and we don't need this feuding, so save a lot more embarrassing than this. We just wanted to set things right. And if we caused any hurt, and we want to apologize,
Well, I'm a grifter. I've ran into situations like this. I've taken my share of bruises along the way. There's no hard feelings.
Look, if we've done you any wrong, we want to make things right.
Well, just coming by to check on me, that's enough. There's no hard feelings.
This Ryan man, he's not interested in farming. And if he marries Zelda, it's definitely a possibility that he'll sell this place and then I'll just be out of a home.
I think Mr. Ryan is a pretty reasonable man. I suggest that you have a talk with him. Look, even if you've got legal rights to the supplies and material that you've put in this house, I'm just not going against the Robertson family. I've represented those folks for years.
Well, Zell, I see you're all dressed up today.
There's going to be a memorial Sunday for Mother in her memory, and I want you to be there.
Well, look, Zell, I'm just, I'm not that good a singer. I'm not just a mess up the service.
All I want you to do is be there, is for Mother, okay?
The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not be in want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He restores my soul. He guides me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen.
Oh Lord, my God.
Sheriff.
Thank you very much.
How you doing?
Fine.
That's good. I see you out of your uniform today.
Yes, ma'am. I'm on vacation this week, and I'm going to be working the farm.
I really appreciate you talking Mr. Robinson into letting me work in the orchard. You know, I'm willing to do my part, but that problem, the back of my hands hurt so bad, I just can't do it. And, I mean, he wants me to supervise, but I mean, I've got to do my sheriff's work.
Well, I understand what you mean, but I reckon I better be heading out towards your tobacco field. You take care.
Okay. Zell, I tell you, I can't take this farm life. Getting up at 4 o'clock in the morning, slopping the hogs, working the fields. I want to go back to the factory and work. I will marry you, but I want you to come with me.
Lee, this is the only life I've ever known. I'll marry you, but you've got to stay here and help me work the fields because this is all I've ever done.
I realize that I should be in your house on this day of worship. But today, I would rather talk with you. Zella, she's a fine young lady. I would marry her. But I can't live this life. I don't like farming. I know. She don't want to leave this place. This is the only life that she knows. Mr. Robinson, he's a fine man. Has a fine family. I know I'll never be able to live up to his standards. Understand what his son is going through now. I don't want to run out on Zelda. I want to do the right thing. I'm just putting everything in your hands.
I bought the lock and put it on the tool shed.
Stickers all over. What'd you say about your tool shed?
I bought the lock and put it on the tool shed.
You did?
And locked up my tools.
Well, we've never done that before.
No, Dad, but this day and time, you can't take any chances on somebody stealing our tools.
Well, I doubt it. But, after all, this is your place as well as mine, so whatever you do, it's fine with me.
Leroy's doing a good job on the farm for Mr. Robertson.
Is that right?
Yeah, he is. But I tell you, Mr. Robertson needs to pay more attention to Sammy.
Well, you know that I don't feel like that Sammy likes too good.
Oh, no, he don't.
Because I know that Sammy had spoke to me a time or two about Lee Ryan.
Uh-huh.
So that's the reason I'm telling you that I don't think Sammy likes him too good.
Yeah, I understand.
But there's nothing I can do. My hands are tied.
Well, I can't do nothing either. I just work for Mr. Robertson. I mean, I've already said a little bit. Yeah,
I know.
So you're gonna lock her up, is that right, Sammy?
Well, Dad, we already got it locked. But I got a tool in here that I'd like to get your opinion on. That's
okay.
A new tool that I bought.
Because I don't think I'm having problems out here, somebody stealing anything. But okay, show me what you got there, Sammy.
I'd like for you to look over there at that tool. Check that tool out.
Sam, what is it with you? Sammy, are you crazy? Are you nuts? You're gonna burn me. You're gonna burn me, kid.
Old man, I've took a lot of junk off of you, but when you decided to sign this land over to that stranger, when it belongs to Zelda and me, you went too far. You're gonna roast for this, because I'm gonna burn this building down with you in it.
With you. Sammy, are you crazy? Are you nuts? You're gonna burn me. You're gonna burn me, kid. Get me out of here. Sammy, get me out of here.
Come on, Dad.
couldn't get it. Sammy, you were going to burn me up. I don't get it. Your change of heart. Does that mean you love me? Let's get out of here. I tell you, really had me frightened.
Mr. Robinson, are you okay? Are you okay?
Explain where that come from. Tell me more where that come from.
You're a very good son.
Oh, Zayla. I'll be right out. You know, Zella, I hear that Helen's in the hospital. What's wrong?
Well, Lee, you know, they had been talking about the operation so that Helen could have the grandchildren Betty always wanted, and they finally came to an agreement, and that's what's going on. Lee, I want to thank you for not fighting with my brother Sammy. I know you did it to help keep unity within this family.
Well, I can't really take a whole lot of credit. I mean, your brother has, so he's got a good right.
Boy, I tell you.
What's up, Dan?
You know, running this farm is... it's not as easy as it looks. But I'm gonna tell you right now, the way that things are right now situated, the crop was actually my problem, my fault. I let the men off last week, which I shouldn't have let the boys go, I mean, you know. But anyway, that tobacco out there is starting to get ripe. And it's gotta move, I mean, we gotta move it quick. Otherwise, we're gonna be in trouble with this stuff.
Well, don't worry, Dad. We'll have enough help, but all of them just can't work at the same time. So what we'll do, we'll run two crews, one in the morning and one in the evening.
You know what? It's a good idea. Now you know why I got you, my number one son.
Well, that being the case, I don't guess it'd bother Mr. Robinson too much about me leaving. I mean, after all, he sees his son now what he used to seeing me.
Thank you, Lawyer Johnson, for saving my career.
Well, I think the jury was fine. They went by what they seen on the first x-ray, but it don't always work out like that.
I don't know how to thank you ladies for all that you've done for me. Well, I'm just going to have to break the news to Mr. Robinson. I'll have to be on the way.
I'm glad that you were here with us. I fixed you a little something for the long trip.
Thank you very much.
Lee, whenever you reach your destination, please keep in touch and we'll write back, okay?
I will.
Thank you.
Well, Mr. Robinson, I don't know how to tell you this, but, well, I'm just not going to be able to make it to church today. Well, me and Zelda, we decided that we want to live in our own worlds, and, well, I'll be going my own way.
Well, Lee, I hope there's no hard feelings.
Nah, Sam, you pack a good punch, real good punch.
Well, best of luck, my boy. Best of luck to you.
Thank you, Mr. Robson.
See you, Lee. What a guy. Sam? A lot of credit. Punching that guy out.
Day had passed away at 2 a.m. Wednesday morning. Please keep our family in your prayers. A friend always, Sal. You know, Sal went on to marry the man of her dreams, and they have four children, Sam and Helen. They have two boys. Their grandchild is a boy. Mr. Robinson's prayers came true. He lived to see six grandchildren and one great-grandchild. Well, it's going to be hard for me to break the news to my wife. I mean, she was really fond of Mr. Robinson. And Mr. Robinson, he was fond of her, too. He'd call her once a year on her birthday. Mr. Robinson said that he always had a good taste when it came to choosing a woman. Well, that's next to Zale, of course.
I guess the day that I drifted into the lives of the Robinson family years ago, I guess there'll always be precious memories to the all of us.